Most of us already know how powerful data is, and what's more important is that it's all pretty much free online if you know how to access and how to use it to automate your life, grow your business, do machine learning, or whatever other goal you have. For this reason, it's really useful to learn web scraping. Web scraping or data scraping is a form of extracting information from a website, a web page, or web app, and saving it in spreadsheet or local file. What is nice about scraping is that you can run it as many times as you need. You can run it every month, every day, or even every 10 minutes to update your database or the source where you would probably save your data. I have recently discovered one of the web scraping tools in the market, and what I really loved about it is how easy and how quick it is to learn and feel comfortable using it if you are already a software developer. You can use it with any programming language that can make API calls, and it offers as well Python and JavaScript API clients. So I'm talking about ScrapingAnt. And now we are going to use its JavaScript API client with Node.js and scrape data about top medium writers with just one single script that contains less than 50 lines of source code. So let me show you our target page for today. So this is the Medium page where we can see the list of top writers for the tag leadership. And when I click on see more, I will get the whole list of all the top writers for leadership. So it would be useful if we scrape the writer's name, the profile URL, and the number of followers. So each writer, as you can see, has a name and there is as well a link to his profile page where we can find the number of followers. So let's create our Node.js project. We are going to need Node.js and npm installed for doing this. So make sure you have them. Then we need to create a new folder. I will create web scraper or web scraping folder. Let's go to it. Then we need to run npm init to create a package.json file in our Node.js project. If you agree to the default informations, you can just press enter. I would like my entry point to be called scraper.js instead of the default one, index.js. So we are going to need two libraries, the ScrapingAnt client. So ScrapingAnt / ScrapingAnt client. ScrapingAnt has a web scraping API that runs a cluster of hundreds of Chrome browsers under the hood in order to perform a scraping task for you. To parse the DOM and extract the data that we want, we will use Cheerio, which is an efficient and light library that exposes an API to parse and manipulate the DOM. It allows you to use the rich and powerful API of jQuery on the server side. So let's install it, npm install Cheerio, npm install -- save dev types node. And this is in order to be able to use the require method to import dependencies. So now we need to go to our project entry point. So this is our project. It has package JSON, and we need to add a file called scraper.js. So I have already prepared a script. Let me paste it, then I will explain it. You need to have an API key for using the ScrapingAnt tool, and this is our main function. What we are doing here, we have defined an empty array, then we have a loop for each tag in this tags array. We take the tag, we call the ScrapingAnt client, then its scrape method, and as parameters or as arguments we are giving the tag URL, which is medium.com/tag/the tag itself. We are giving for which country we want to use the proxy. In this case, it's for the USA. And here we have a JavaScript snippet. What this JavaScript snippet doing is just to click. As you can see here, there is a call for click on the p element that contains the text CMOR. And if I go back to Chrome, so here this is the place in our screen that we want to scrape. So here, not this one, yes, it's this one. Here we have a p element that contains the text CMOR, and when I click on it, I will get this view with the whole list of top writers. So after that, we will get this list as HTML. What we want to do after that is get data from tag page. So we are calling this function, which is using Cheerio. It loads the HTML, which is the result, which is this one. Then we are getting the dialog, which is the div element that has the role attribute, and the value for role is dialog. Let me show it to you. So after clicking on the CMOR, we have this view, and as you can see, it's a div. It has a role attribute and its value is dialog. So let's open it. So here we have the title of the dialogue. We don't need it. We need to focus on the content of this div. Let's come back. So after having the element that is holding the dialogue, we need to find the A element in order to extract the URL to the writer profile. So we have now for each writer a div. And here the HTML tag A, it contains the URL to the profile of this top writer. So here we have the list of all the A and the H2 where the name of the writer is inside the A. So that's why we are looping through this links list. And for each one, we extract the value for the attribute href and we execute get full URL first. And what this method is doing, it checks if the URL starts with slash, then it returns the URL back, but with the prefix https://medium.com. And let me explain why I'm doing this. So this is the URL for this first top writer. Let me show you. So here, for example, we have a different URL. It does not start by slash. For this case, we don't need to add a prefix. So since we have two different patterns for the URLs, we need this method. Then we save the whole URL of the writer in this result object. Then we extract the text in the H2 element. And this would be the name of the writer. And we push this result object in this array page results, and this would be the return value of get data from tag page. So after finishing the execution of this part, we will have the list of all top writers' names and their profile web pages, but we need the number of followers for each one of them. That's why we need to loop again through the list of our all writers. For each one, we call the URL, proxy country is USA, and we have to use the await because we have to wait until the data will be returned. So after calling the page, we run extract followers count function with the HTML of the profile page as argument. And let me show you the extract followers count. It has only one line. Just a moment. So if I go to the top, I have already defined a constant which contains a regular expression. And let me explain why this regular expression. So if I go to my profile page, here there is in this header the word followers and before it the number of followers. I have over 1800 followers, so the number of followers will be digits then followers, or digits then k then followers, or if I have, for example, 1 million or x million followers, then I will find not k but m. That's why this regular expression is looking for numbers from 0 to 9 followed by k or m and dot one or more. So, and with this little function we will get the list of followers. And after getting this number, we will push it again into the writer object that has already URL name. We will push it and save it in the attribute followers. After that, all I need to do is to call the console log in order to see on my terminal if my code has worked or not. So now I need to call node scraper.js. Depending on the number of tags you have set in your script, you notice that this will take some time in order to return the result. Just be patient and wait for it. Then you will get the JSON data on your console similar to the following extract I have already. So this is also the same script that I have executed. And after waiting for a moment, I have received this list of writers. As you can see, there is for each one the URL, the name, the number of followers. So guys, I hope this was helpful I tried to keep it short. I have put a link in the description of the video to the ScrapingAnt tool and to an article with more details. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button to my channel.